For the archive value function, I use the same tag names I used in my current value example, and I've added a heading, value at 9 a.m. this morning, and I've added a time to use as a reference. You'll notice I use the Excel function equals today, left right paren plus 9 over 24. And I'm allowing that as my time field for my cell reference. So I will click inside the box in which I want the results to appear. I will select pi archive value. And in this case, I'll do the same thing that I did in my earlier example for tag name. I will select the range of tags that I have on my spreadsheet. And for my timestamp, I will select the time I have at the top of the screen. I don't necessarily need a timestamp since I am going to retrieve the specific value at 9 a.m. And so when I click OK, you will see all of the values displayed that were exactly at 9 a.m. It's important to remember that even though you don't have values in the archives every second of the day, unless you are scanning every tag once per second and not using exception and compression, then it's quite likely that when you ask for a value at a certain time, that there really isn't a value at that time, and you are receiving what's called an interpolated value. Here's an example of a timeline, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, let's call these minutes, and some values up on the left. And you'll notice that there's no value at the 2 mark, at the 2-minute mark. However, if someone asks the Pi server for a value at that time, we will interpolate between the previous and next values and return a value to the user. So, therefore, when you ask for a specific archive value, you're going to get a value every time. I've added a section below that shows the result of those. And you'll notice that if you do select the archive value function, there are different retrieval modes. We have previous, interpolated and auto, next, and exact time. And you'll notice that when we ask for a value at 9 a.m., the default method is auto, and auto pretty much does the same things as interpolated. Previous pretty much does the same thing as previous only. Previous actually means at that time or previous. So if you did hit the number right on, the previous and the exact time would be the same. The same logic applies to the next. So when I ask for an auto, I actually get an interpolated value, because you'll notice that you can prove this by asking for 9 a.m. and asking for a retrieval method of exact time. And you'll see you get the results no events found. If you look at the previous and next values, you see the previous value was at 8:35 and the next value was at 9:05. So when we asked for the value at 9 a.m., we simply interpolated between the previous and the next values for a result. Now, the interpolated and auto methods are almost the same. The only real difference comes in when you have digital or discrete tags. And you can see in the diagram that we have up here of a trend, we have a blue trace, which looks like an analog tag, and we have a green trace, which looks like a discrete or digital tag. And if we ask for a value at 1 p.m. or 1300 hours, and let's assume there is no value in the archive at exactly that moment, if we ask for it using the interpolated method, we will get the same result for the blue trace, because the blue trace for non-digital states, the interpolated and auto methods are the same. However, with the green trace, with the digital state, if we ask for the interpolated, we will get the actual interpolated time, whereas auto will retrieve the exact time of that value was set. So interpolating and auto mean slightly different things for digital or discrete tags, and they mean the same thing for floats and integers and things like that.